Welcome everyone to this Force Friday. I hope you've all had an exciting week, hopefully an interesting week, a week of education and drawing and learning. And today we're here to talk about more education, right? So we're gonna talk about the mouth. Prior week, we talked about the eyes. So we're dealing obviously with different parts of the face, just to give you a better understanding on how to draw, right? Human head is really complicated. And I want to preface this as I did last week with, you shouldn't go in and just draw the mouth. Like, you really need to understand force, form, and shape. You know, try to get those three major pillars of skillful drawing underneath you before really trying to tackle the idiosyncrasies of expression, right, that occur between the relationship of, for instance, the eyes and the mouth, right? So with that, let's just say a quick hello. How are you doing, Mritunjay?
Hey, Mike. Yeah, doing good. I'm pretty happy, you know, we are continuing this kind of series, what we did last week with the eyes, and now with the mouth, you know. So it's really going to connect like those like two main parts for expression, I would say.
Yeah.
And yeah, hopefully like give all these guys like better better ways to like express themselves.
Yeah, you know, the face, I have to say, I'm just as guilty of this as probably the next guy. But when it comes to figure drawing, especially first of all, in gesture drawing, you usually don't get to the face, right? So you try to tell story through the human body, right? Through the expression of a pose and mannerism. And that is very valid. I mean, it's a pretty big deal to tell story and emotion through the entire human body. But as we talked about the other week, right, the most important thing is the face. We all look at each other's faces. We read each other's faces, the expressions in each other's faces, eyes and mouths and the whole shtick, right? So, and there are ways, you know, you can get some small stuff in the face and a gesture, but it usually happens at that more like 3 to 5 minute drawing. By 5 minutes, I try to get definitely some of the face, you know, in there. And just the importance of it. I have a lot of students right now that are working on portfolios, right, to get jobs or get into schools. And, you know, on those drawings, I keep bringing back to them, like, heads, hands, feet, you know, like, get the details in those at least 5 minute plus drawings. And if it's a portfolio for a job, really important to have those expression sheets, you know, and show how a character acts, like, who are they and how are they expressing themselves with their facial features, right? And so here we are. That's why I think this is really important. We're trying to understand this. Nothing more important than somebody else's face, right?
Mm.
So let's get to it. We have a lot to cover today. Let's head over to Photoshop. Hello, everyone. As you guys are making your way in, welcome, welcome. Thanks for joining. This week, a little different than last week, we're going to talk a little bit more about anatomy and stuff also at the front. I went in, I like to share some kind of fun stuff with you guys at the front. And I thought, like, what are some of the most famous mouths, right, that we all would know? And the first thing I could think of was the Joker. I'm like, if there's one mouth that comes to mind, it would probably be the Joker's smile, right? So this is from the Joker film, so he doesn't have the crazy gashes and stuff that they had in the other Batman movies. But still, it brings you to the clown, the idea of a clown or painting expression on your face. And I was thinking about this before we came in today. I find it really interesting that an upward curvature is representative of happiness and then a downward curvature is representative of sadness, right? And that kind of plays out across other things in our world. And I'm kind of doing this off the cuff here, just things that come to my mind when I think about this, the awareness of this. It goes anywhere as far as like a wilting plant, right? And the sort of death of that versus it being really, you know, spry and lifted and upward. I think about cars, you know, the front of cars sometimes look like human faces, right? Because of the headlights. And you'll see that the way the grills and stuff on the car are done makes a car look either aggressive with its eyes, right? Its headlights and its mouth. Sometimes you can see it on the back set of a car and like how much meaning you can give to that, right? To the setup of the back of a car or the front of the car, it looks like there's expression. Obviously, there's really no expression, but we can imbue it with that. And to back up again, I just find it interesting that downward means something to us and upward means something to us. And that we imbue the things around us in our world with that same idea. There's things that are just natural, that are in nature, like the plant, all the way to our smiles and frowns, and how that affects design, that it's ubiquitous. And because it's ubiquitous, we can push that along other drawings, right? We could tell stories, there's acting and performance, right? You could do it in comics, right? And bring these concepts to your artwork because of the generality, the ubiquity, right? That we all go through the same thing. So I'm just sharing with you my awareness. I think it's a kind of big thing. And I always try to be aware of that really big idea. So, you know, here, I thought, again, it's famous ones, right? Rocky Horror Picture Show is like a super famous mouth, right? And then I was just thinking about the frown again versus the grin. You know, I just think that's interesting, like downwardness, we read that as something. And last but not least, man, I used to do this with my kids all the time. It's turning your head upside down, sticking some eyes and nose and a mouth on that, and just how hysterical that actually is and how weird that suddenly looks. We're also very aware of like what a mouth looks like and the orientation of teeth in a mouth. And the tongue at the bottom of your mouth and flipping that upside down and how awkward that actually looks. Yeah, I actually have video of me and my kids like singing songs and doing this. It's pretty damn hysterical. And you can find this all over YouTube. I mean, it's tons of people that do this. Just really, really funny.
It's so creepy.
Yeah, it is a little. It can be, that's for sure. So anatomy. We didn't really get into anatomy last week with the eyes, but you'll see the structure of the anatomy around the eyes and the mouth is... there's a similarity to the anatomy of those regions and these, you know, these flatter, round muscles that move around the mouth and that move around the eyes. And those give those areas of the human face a lot of opportunity, right? A lot of manipulation. I think, you know, when I teach anatomy, and this is from the Force Anatomy book, by the way, when I teach anatomy, one of the first things I try to bring up to everyone is be aware that the idea of a muscle is for it to contract, right? So if you look at the mouth and you look at all the muscles around it that connect to the skull, you'll see how many different areas around there are these moments of contraction that can pull the mouth up and down and left and right, right? So you got all these rubber bands, right, that are attached from bone to the muscle of the mouth. And you have the muscle of the mouth, right? So when this contracts, it helps you make your mouth tight, right? And straight if you equaled out the tension on the top to the bottom. And these are going to pull the mouth up and down and left and right, you know, based around the roundness of this, right? As you can see, it says oris here, and the same with the orbicularis oculi, right? So you've got this concept of roundness even in the naming itself. So, you know, just be aware, right? This is the machinery that's going on underneath the skin, right, as to how this stuff works. I'm trying to give you a little bit of a simpler education here without going into all that detail, but here's a map, right? This is what's going on. These are the machines. This is the engine that's making it all work. And that leads me to this, which is what we're going to talk about. You know, last week we did eyes. You could see this is also from the anatomy book. It's understanding like directional and applied forces. And the same thing happens in the mouth. We talked about the eye, you know, the mask even last week. We'll talk more about that as well today. So let's discuss, right? I'm going to go a little further into detail here. This is from the anatomy book also. So you can see the eye mask, and then there's the mouth mask, right? The mouth mask. So we're dealing with this region of the face. And the way I'm taking this conversation is just to start with the concept of these shapes based on forces, right? So last week we talked about the eyes. Let me get here to swatches. You know, the mouth, interestingly, is almost looks like a line all on its own, right? Here's just the center line of the mouth, right? So you could start with that to help you with expression. You know, it's like, do I want somebody smiling? You know, is the smile asymmetrical, right? Is it like that? Are they frowning, right? Is the mouth straight? Is it a subtle frown? So there's a very big difference between doing this and doing this. Right. And when you start to combine that with what's going on in the eyes, right, that's a pretty big deal. Right. So there's so much subtlety in the eyes and how much variation there is in expression between extremes, right? Almost the in-betweens of eye expression. That the same thing happens in the mouth, the subtleness. You know, you look at somebody's mouth And they just do a subtle thing and going from straight and just lifting up the corner of their mouth. And that does something, right? And we recognize that. I think what's amazing to me is always, again, how sensitive we are as people to each other's faces and expression. So just being aware of that. And this to me, these are like forces, you know? So when the mouth does this, it's literally a force to me. And you'll see the skin on the edges of the mouth goes like this, right? It'll push in. On a side note here, this reminds me of something, which is, you know, you'll see in some cartoons, the style is to do this, right? I'm sure you've all seen a mouth like that before, which is fine. I'm not the hugest fan of this just because the corner of the mouth to me should be reacting to the force of the corner of the mouth. So the curve would go more like this because you're pushing into it. If somebody had a full cheek, for instance, right? Like they have food in their mouth, like a chipmunk, right? Then I can see this and it kind of makes sense because you're pushing the force of the cheek against the force of the mouth, right? Otherwise, I want to push up into it. And that also leads to another small trick to be aware of is when you're dealing, let's say it's the eye line and here's the nose, right? So here's the nose and you have the mouth. As the mouth pushes up like this and you get that force pushing in there and you have the eyeball here, you'll typically see, depending on how high this goes, you'll typically see that force get pushed up here as well, right? Because what you're getting here is this shape. You see this shape right here? So that, by the way, happens to be a great straight to curve shape because you got the curve of this versus the straight of the bottom. And you want that lip tuck in the corner to push the cheek, right? This is the mass of the cheek right here, right? This is the cheek. So you want that cheek to respond, you know, up here to the eye. So if you see, you know, any artists that are doing that, you'll see this in a lot of Disney artists because they're very aware of this. That they'll push up against the face, you know, and talking about Disney, where did I first learn that? Well, you know, believe it or not, I first actually learned that drawing Mickey Mouse, right? So it's like when you have Mickey Mouse like this, and you have, here's his centers, right? And you have his nose comes in and sweeps up like this to that cheek line right there, right? Where that mouth is going to tuck in there. Right. But it pushes up against this. Right. So here's that shape. So this is curved, but not as curved as that. Right. It's like a stiffer curve. Right. And that gives us this shape. Right. So that's when I was like, oh, that's really interesting. I got to start looking for that in the human face or if I were drawing a human character, you see. So keep that in mind. So getting to the mouth shape, right. These forces start developing shapes. And the mouth shape basically goes from here. Let me just sketch in a jaw very quickly here. All right, so here's a jaw. We have the mouth here, and here's the center, and the nose is sitting here. The mouth shape basically moves from the corners of the nostrils, right? So here's the like ball of the nose, and it sweeps up like this. It's the corner of the nostrils, like kind of tucked in right here, right? That pulls down. And this is, you know, as you get older, you'll get, you know, jowls, right? You get these like edges and this pulling of the flesh here. And here's the mouth. So it'll pull around to the corners of the mouth like this. And then here's your chin, right? The structure of your chin is sitting in like right here. So this will pull down to the chin, kind of loop over this and then come up the other side. So you end up with the shape. And that's the shape that you see here. Right. So that's the definition of like the mouth mask, right? Is it looks like this. And then as you can see in the drawings over to the left, as you're drawing those forces that we just discussed to express different emotions, that creates different kinds of shapes. So shape is just a way of seeing the abstraction of the expression, right? To see, and it starts giving you a broader sense of a shape on the face instead of just the lines. You know, of it. Again, the mouth is kind of interesting. Notice I haven't drawn lips or anything yet. Mritunjay will go a little bit more into that. The center line of the mouth, the division in the mouth all on its own gives you a ton of, like I said, expressiveness. You can build up basically the rest of the mouth and the mouth shape around that, right? So if I were to even take it out of the context here of this face that I just sketched out, right? And again, I do something like this. Make that a little darker here, right? And I know the nose is, let's say, up here, right? I could start building out the shape. And let's say this is center, right? I can build the shape up You see? So that shape takes on the aliveness of the mouth, right? The mouth is really the driving factor, right? That's the force of this region of the face. And then seeing that shape helps express that. Besides the fact that shape helps you design, because now you're not just thinking about lines, you're actually thinking about shapes. And the shapes, you want them to feel like they're fluid. You want to make them feel like they're forceful. You know, you can see that this shape, in essence, I could break this shape down now to two shapes because I have a shape on the top and a shape in the bottom. It's like, are those shapes good? If I break that down further, it's like, well, I've got, you know, I've got this strong like curve of force pushing down over here versus the nose, and here, you know, here I'm pushing up versus the chin, right? So being aware of these sort of more and more micro shapes, right? And how are they working to create a appealing shape design, which we talked about, you know, before. Let's see, any questions in the chat so far? You know, I don't know Sonic that well, but yeah, from what I know, Sonic, you know, almost all of the big character designs that are out there have been somehow influenced by Mickey Mouse. I have to say, like, when I look at characters out there in the world, so many of the famous ones, I'm like, oh, that's really Mickey Mouse with this different nose. That's Mickey Mouse with a slightly different mouth or different ears, right? And Sonic is very close to Mickey, most definitely. The whole smiling with your eyes thing. Yeah. Yeah, there is a, so to Gary's point, you know, there is a big thing about even what's a genuine smile versus an ingenuous smile. And, you know, it's like how much pinching is there up in the face and in the cheeks and the sort of crow's feet of your eyes, right? Like how much is that working? We can talk about the human face and expression for days, right? There's so much science behind this, and there's been so much investigation into the expression of the human face. Let's see. Yeah, so Sonic... Yeah, Kevin, I got your email. I emailed you back, actually. So that's an interesting take on maybe what number 200 is. Yes, I think it might be a valid idea. It is a valid idea. It might be the idea, is I guess my point. So, you know, that's what I want you to be aware of. I just want you to be aware of the shapes of this. Now, the shapes, you know, when you do get to the lips and so on, yeah, the same thing is very important, is to be aware that the lips have appeal to them. You know, what we're trying to watch out for, again, folks, is we don't want to hit the bad shapes, right? We don't want a shape in the mouth that looks like that. We don't want a shape in the mouth that looks like this, which is where it's double curved, basically, like so. And we're trying to watch out for that double concave shape also, right? So this is all the stuff that creates appeal, and it comes all the way down to something as small as the lips. So you'll see even in the lips themselves, I'm trying to be aware of those straight to curve shapes, right? So I think that's all I want to talk about when it comes to the main forces and the shape of this. We still have three more like things to cover today. So I'm going to hand it over to Mritunjay. He'll start talking about structure in this. And then you guys will come back to me, and I have some really interesting stuff I want to share with you about further design. So let me hand this over to you, Mritunjay. Okay, all yours.
Yeah. All right. So let's start. I'm going to take over here. Yes. Okay. You can see the screen?
Yes.
All right. Great. So, all right, guys. You know, thank you, Mike, for sharing the mouth mask. Now we kind of finished our set, you know, overall. You know, and now, you know, what you guys can actually do here is you can take, let me take my brush here. So you can take, you can actually connect the previous stream, you know, which is like our eye mask. This is just look like sunglasses right over here. And then you can take the mouth mask, you know, on the bottom. And they can, like, you have like unlimited possibilities with it, you know, just like so many different types of expressions. This abstraction, you know, yeah, I just want to like highlight the word abstraction here. This is like the abstraction you want to start with, like simplification. And simplification, you start with something simple and then just add more and more details to make it as complex as you want to, or you keep it as simple as you want to again. And then you can literally start with something like a smiley, right? Something like this, see something like that. I mean, look at that, right? So I have this like eyebrows like this, but the smiling face like that. But then I could be doing something like this. Okay. So that's what Mike was explaining before is like this is like very important. Yeah. And that brings us to the design of the mouth. So let's cover the design of the mouth, right? And then we'll jump back to Mike, for some shape design and stuff. And then we'll turn back to like for like a rendering phase, okay, of the lip as well. All right, so start with some form, okay. Now before starting with the form, yeah, I mean we can we can cover everything in here. So what the yeah no like I just like wrote the wrapping in here. For that, what the form of the like lip looks like. Now obviously we know that we basically have an upper lip, which is I'm gonna make it really, really simple for you, right? Just like a leaf, in a way. There's like the upper lip and the bottom lip, right? I know it doesn't look like this, but just let's just consider this, okay? So it's like a leaf, just an upper lip and a lower lip, okay? Definitely the thing is when we try to look at from the sideways, okay, the thing is, it is this way, right? So it's actually going this way, inside, okay, then the outside, okay, so it's something like this. So on a very, very basic level, this is what's happening to our lips, okay? So it's basically going this inside and then the outside. If you look at from side, this will basically just be going inside and then coming outside, okay? And then we have like a little bit gap, and then we basically have the chin. So I know it looks like an eye, for some reason, but it's very weird. But this is the same idea, right? It's actually going inside and then coming outside. So I would say this is the basic form, okay, of the lip that you want to follow. You really want to follow this 3D structure of it in order to understand like what's coming ahead, which is how to light it, for example. Imagine like if you're like. And usually the light is from the top. Usually, we are considering like just a person maybe walking normally and like in a normal environment where this light is coming from sky. Right? So what you have basically is you have light coming from top, which means you see like because this is just going inside, right? So the light is going to fall on this face, which is the bottom one, which means what? Right, the shadow, this other guy, this upper guy would be in shadow right over here. Okay, so something like that. And you start to see what's happening. You start to see what happened is, yeah, we are getting some sort of like lip design over here. Talking about, so that's really simple. Like that's the simple expression, simple expressive ideas. Now, what do you want to do? Like, how would you start like with the lip here? So the top lip, right? Basically, you start with. I usually start with the same. I usually start with this gap. Do you know, Mike, what this is called? The gap here. I forget the name of this, but it's
It's
basically
like the philtrum, something like that, right? You mean
filtrum. Yeah.
the space down, yeah, between on the top of the mouth?
Yes,
Yeah, I
exactly. It
think it's
is this.
called the philtrum.
Yeah, now forget it, really,
I
maybe
forget it all the time too. I'm shocked I remember today, but I'm pretty sure it's the philtrum.
yeah, so anyways, so that gap, right, I'm just gonna call it the gap,
Yeah,
okay, let's
it's the
give
philtrum. Yeah, I double
it
checked.
a so basically it does have a V shape at the end, okay. Now if you look at this the space here, it's basically a little bit dip down, which means if I go across contour lines, it's going to go this way, like this, and like this. Okay, so that is what that's how it's made. And then you basically see it does have like a V shape at the end. And from the front, you basically have that V shape. And usually, it's a very weird or funny metaphor. I just like try to like build a heart, out of this. Okay, try to build a heart out of this V shape. right over here. Okay. So once I get that, then it's kind of like the first step, you know, first step of like building upper lip. And then from here, you basically have those like C curves, okay, over here. Now, really important. I mean, this thing, like I cannot stress enough like how important this is. Usually when you're doing like very quick gestures or maybe even small gestures, let's say this is your page, right? You're making a gesture this big. It's like a small face that you're drawing. So you cannot, not many times or not all the times you can do this, right? It's like do this kind of detailing. The one thing you do is just, this is a shadow that I'm talking about, okay? So at the end of your mouth, you know, basically, at the end of your lips, you know, basically we have this kind of shadow over here. So you just do this and you just do like a little bit of like a stroke there underneath. This is for the bottom lip. Okay, and that's it, right? So many a times you do this, like in quick gesture drawing as well. Very, 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 very quick, actually, by the way. So you don't draw the upper lip, you don't draw the lower lip, like separately. You just basically do the shadow and the shadow on the corner of the mouth, and that's it, right? So it's a very, very quick way to just, and even express. So for example, if I do this, see, that's kind of a little bit smiling, right? If I do this, that's sad, right? Pissed off, you know, things like that. So it's very, very quick. This is very, very important. You definitely want to get that. This is actually talking about 3D space. Again, talking about that leaf thing in 3D. It's actually your mouth like going in, like dipping down in, right? Which brings us to the wrapping, okay? We'll come more on that. Yeah, so let's get this lip design done and then we'll see some wrapping around. Okay, how does this wrap around the mouth? Or teeth, I should say. Yeah. So anyway, get this like I usually like do the C curves, you know, just very, very quick. And then draw these shapes here. Now Mike is gonna cover more on that. Wait a second. Yeah. So getting the heart, right? So it's a quick recap, right? Getting this space here. It does have this V kind of shape in here. It's a little bit dipped down, as you can see. And then you can just like quick build a quick like heart shape out of that. Then what you do here is you can deepen this down a little bit, like making this a little bit darker. Yeah, because the mouth is going in, right? So this kind of shape. And on the bottom, you can draw these like two volumes here. Again, like very very simple, just two volumes down in here, right? And that's it, right? You'll come up with a general lip design. It's like the center right over here. And again, just like, you know, talking about faces, man, it's so many, like there's so many designs. That's what makes us different, you know, like each other's face different. You cannot just stick on like one thing and say, okay, this is the lip design for everyone. You're not just going to learn that. This is very general, right? This is very, very, very general. Now, I mean, I've seen so many variations of like mouth. Some people would have almost like non-existent upper lip, you know, just very super, super thin, but could have like a giant bottom lip. Could be this, you know, or something like that. So you can always like play with the variations, you know. So what I'm trying to bring here is like, don't stick to one, but just just kind of like experiment with and just understand this gender idea, and then just play with the shapes and forms. Okay, so here's a very, very quick lip design, and then obviously you can shade on the top to have that common lighting scenario. Okay. Now, one thing to remember here is this heart shape is known to like overlap, okay, a little bit overlap, you know, this bottom part a little bit, which is bring like some overlaps here. So now that is actually help us, that will actually help us like design these forms in 3D, and then it brings us a lot of like cool depth, you know, into our drawings. So coming back to this side view here, or 3/4, I should say. See, I'm cutting that V shape over there. I'm still carrying on with this like almost a C, but just the S, right? You know, in the end. So I'm doing this. Now, the thing with the 3/4 view here is, yeah, people make these big mistakes. You know, they make it like this, you know, they make it like really, really flat. Just want to make sure that you're like wrapping around, okay? Which means this is going to be a smaller one, okay? So something more like this. Wait a second. Yeah, something more like this, okay? And I see what, just like I said, you start to like build that heart shape out, okay? So I'm building that. And that is my center line. And I'm using that heart shape to overlap, to like penetrate into this region, you know, into this bottom region over here. And the same thing, right? So I would use this almost to C again, but just right in the end, it's almost like an S, right? Yeah, doing this. So again, see, I'm focusing on the shadow here. Wait a sec. Yeah, something like this. I'm focusing on that shadow again. And then here's the space. Okay, so here's that. Here's the gap again. Just gonna call it the gap. Right. Force Team 2024. And at the bottom, you see like this heart shape is yeah, overlapping. It's overlapping it, which brings out the depth, right? Which brings out very good depth into the drawing. And it's such you're not the lip is not flat. Okay. I like it better previously.
I
Just
think we
wanna
should
just
also mention in here, Mritunjay, just to cover it. I know it's super academic, but that the mouth is controlled obviously by the teeth, right? And that you have to learn how to wrap the lips around the curvature, you know, the teeth themselves, right? And how that, like you're doing there with that lip, the left side of the lip is so much smaller and shorter than the right side of the lip because of that curvature.
Yeah, I was just about to jump to that.
Okay,
But
great.
yeah, right, you know. So anyway, so here's that, guys. You know, here's like a little bit of orbicularis oculi muscle, right? You'd see this this little bit of like bump around the mouth. It's just like again the muscle peeking out there, you know, just kind of chilling, kind of like that. And maybe not that much visible, maybe just a little bit visible. Yeah, kind of like that. All right. So and why this is happening, just like Mike's saying, and obviously you want to do this right with it. So it's kind of like that. All right. So that wrapping, you know, now it brings us to this this heading over here, is like the wrapping around. The thing with, you know, when not this very weird and funny metaphor again, for the skull, when I'm teaching like skull drawing, this is what I use every time. What you want to do is, and I would like bring a very quick skull here as well. Just let's see, keep it over here. I'll make it a really quick skull here. So very simple skull. So basically, we have our eye sockets over here, okay? And then we have this arch over there. Now at the bottom of this arch, what really happens is your teeth, you know, like your teeth are starting to build up. Now, the problem with this one is not the problem, but you know, students face a very constant problem just making their teeth look very flat, you know. They have a problem. I mean, they have a problem of like making their teeth look very, yeah, I mean, rounded, right? Like they're not able to like wrap it round. So the thing here is teeth goes this way. So it's in the front and it's on the side as well. And what people do, they make it like really, really flat. And you see like the skull is like in this 3D structure. It looks very, very weird, you know. So the thing here, what you want to use You can do two ways, not two ways, but you can do it two step wise. Okay. Just want to make sure that you can follow this metaphor first, and then you can just like make it a little bit more squarish, right? Or you can just go the other way. I just use this way. I know like Mike is doing the other way, but it's fine. I'll just tell you here. Basically, what you want to do is take a tuna can. So here's a dead tuna or sardines, I don't know. And so you cut it in half, right? You cut that in half, you get this half-cutted can, and then you place this around here. Okay. Basically, see, I can place this like half-cut can over here. So it gives you like some sort of structure, okay? Some sort of like form in here. Okay. And then what you do is you square it off, okay? So let's say this can is not cylindrical, but it's a little squared off, just like this. Now, while you're squaring it off, if you get the volume, well, you're doing it for the sake of, first of all, the form itself. Like this is like much more accurate, right? So, yeah, this squarish form is like much more accurate, but at the same time, you're also worrying about the turning edges, right? Turning edges, if any of you guys don't know, it's basically the edge where the plane changes happens. Okay, so let's say the turning edge of the upper section of the skull is right over here, right at this point. So this is the front, this is the side. Okay, so that's our turning edge. So that turning edge inside, not inside, the turning edge on the teeth, like that's happening over there. No, so from here you can just basically turn it. And you see, like now I'm squaring it off a little bit. So this is like wrapping around. So the teeth, would come in the front and would like go farther back into the skull. And yeah, using these two techniques, you cannot get wrong with it. This is the perfect direction and a simple direction that you want to like head into. And then what happens is you start with your jaw and there we go, right? So very quickly, just easily creating that jaw over there. I like that. Okay. And there we go. Like you basically have your skull ready. Yeah, that's what's happening. So what's happening, like let's just take this here. Let's take the form in here. And now want to start with the teeth here, right? A little bit of squares off, just like I said. Again, you can go that from that way to this way or from this way to that way. I think this one is good, because you're worrying about the turning edge. So the teeth is wrapping around like this, and then what you want to do is you want to start building off your forms based on this structure. You see? A little bit like this, and then see, I'm turning that in. Okay, so you want to make sure that as you're coming out, you're going in from the side. The skull has this pattern. It's like go out in, out in, out in, out in kind of structure. Okay, so for example, if you come to the brow ridge, you start with going out, brow ridge, going in, right? Here's your eye socket, right? Then you go out again for the tip of the nose, not for the tip of the nose, but this nasal bone, right? The tip of this nasal bone. You come in again, go out again, come back in and again, out again for the teeth, in again, right? Out again and in again, right? So it's like really this zigzag pattern is what you're going for. So here also in the lips, you basically go in, right, this way, and then you come out at the bottom. It's basically this way. By the way, the top lip, just make sure it's like a little bit, I mean, it's protruded out a little bit more, okay? And then the bottom lip is, it's a little bit in, it's protruded in. Not protruded, but yeah. And then here's the gap. Okay. There's a little S kind of thing. There's a little shadow there. That's that shadow. It's important to get. Then you have the lip going this way. And then again, you can just do all the details like afterwards. Yeah. And then this way, right? You can use and just talking about academics, you know, Mike was mentioning it. You can like use circles and things like that to just perfectly line this up, you know. Yeah. And then see, I'm just using a center line to check sure the volume over there. Okay.
I want to share with everyone, you know, be aware of how much perspective Mritunjay is using, right? Again, it's not so simple as just draw a mouth, right? It's like understanding these different planes in three-dimensional space, how they go along a subtle curvature, how they cut into one another, these sort of ins and outs of the profile of the face, right? Which is why I say this isn't where it starts. This is when you've got a good grasp of perspective. Plus, you're trying to get expression with force, right? And plus, we're going to talk more about design afterwards. But there's a lot. It takes a lot to be able to draw this stuff, you know, from imagination or even studying it. So it's fine for you to follow along, for instance, with Mritunjay and go and draw this mouth right now. But that's very different than knowing, having the knowledge that it takes to actually draw the mouth, right?
Oh, Mike, I was trying to like, you scared everyone using perspective.
Scared him off. It's like the boogie monster of the boogeyman of art as perspective.
I was like, oh no, now they're
now they're
scared.
Gonna run away. Yeah, forget it. Go learn something else.
So you wanna share something about the shape design, Mike, really quick?
Yeah, I'm ready to go.
Yeah, okay, great.
All right, here we go, guys. So that's a ton of information about just like the construction of it. And, you know, as Mritunjay said, and as I just said, you know, you really got to know your perspective. I wanted to share with you, to me, something that's just really fun. I really love playing with design. And I think there's a really strong need for this out there. Anytime I post anything on my Instagram that deals with design, I put a thing up on hands and feet, for instance, a few weeks back. It gets a lot of traction, which just shows me like, wow, okay, people are hungry for this. And the same thing goes with for the mouth, right? So one of the main tools besides force shape, one of the main tools is playing with proportion, you know? So it's like, is somebody's mouth like this, right? And here, let's just take the same exact shape, right? So Command J, and I'm gonna move this down. Let's just take this shape, for instance, Command J. All right, and I've got three of the same shape here. And let's just say that, here, let me put these together in one layer. You know, and I put, let's put one line in the center of that shape. And then right away, things can change because I can put that line high in the shape. I could put the center line low in the shape. What am I doing? As soon as I do that, here, let's put a center through all these two. As soon as I do that, I've changed proportions. So this one here is 50-50, right? This is maybe like a 30-70. And then here we have a 70-30, right? That already, right there, you have three options on how to draw the mouth. Believe me, there are thousands, right? Thousands and thousands of options. This is just one. So what I did is this what I call the bounding box, and this concept is in the character design from Life Drawing book, the Force one. This idea of the bounding box and playing with proportion to help you form opinion and be able to iterate on design, right? So let's just make the same mouth over and over again, right? I'm gonna, just to make it simple, I'm gonna go, you know, in here, create a V, I'm gonna go all the way down to the center of the mouth with it and get out to the corners, right, like this, and then go right down to the middle. So very simple, meaning how I'm using the grid, the proportions, is basically the same thing, right? So I'm doing this, I'm doing this, I'm doing this, and I'm doing this, right? And just notice how different that is, right? Look at this, that philtrum, right? Look how big it is, how deep it digs down into the shape of the mouth here versus this. So, wow, go figure, right? Look at the variation in these three drawings based on me understanding just the bounding box and the proportion of the top to the bottom, right? Now, there's way more that can happen than this, right? That's what's so exciting to me. And this is how I iterate. I've done this as an art director. I've taught this to concept artists that I've managed, because it lets you really start to open up your mind to changing shape and design, right? It's a pretty big deal. So now if I take this, let's Command J this a couple of times and pull this down and pull this down, right? There's other things here I can play with again, right? So let's just, I took one of the lips, right? This bottom one from here. Let's see. And I brought this up here, right? And I'm going to do it again. What if I decide to change the distance, right? From here to here. So now I'm talking about this proportion. You see? It's like, okay, well, maybe one of them, I just get rid of it. I know people who've got lips that where they don't really have that philtrum affect the lip, right? So very simply, I can go, you know what? I'm just going to ignore it entirely. The lip is very smooth. It's like this, right? Whoops. Right? It's like that. It's very smooth. It's very smooth along the top, right? But just to show you my point, so I want you to be aware, that's another option, right? Another option. Let's see, Command Z that. So now I'm back here. What if I make it really narrow? I go from here to here. Now I have somebody's lip with this all the same ideas as before, but I close the philtrum down, right? Now it's got this width. So their lip looks like that. That's very different. And then maybe I go really wide, right? Maybe it's like this. I want you to be aware of how much control you have over the look of things, over the design. One of you guys was saying how you're doing character design work right now. Like, this is it, right? This is where the rubber hits the road. Proportion is huge. Now, it's one thing to learn the tool of proportion. All right, so there's another mouth. Look at how varied those look just by me opening and closing that. But what does it mean, right? So what? Like, we can play around with these mouth shapes. Well, that's where you start learning more of the abstractions of shape design and, how do I give this meaning? What can it actually say about the character, right? It might be that this, hold on, I just want to get a tone in here for you guys so you could see it a little better, right? So here's this shape. See black? Ah, there we go. That's what the problem was. There. So here's this shape compared to this shape compared to this shape, right? What does it mean? I mean, it can go as far as, how open someone is emotionally. It could mean like this one here feels very sharp to me, the verticality of this. I might take those proportions and bring it over to the character. There might be I could use that shape and say, well, that's the shape of the person's torso. Maybe this person's torso, maybe they're wider, or maybe they're more V-shaped in their body. You see, I can actually use that shape as a shape language for the entire character, right? It could mean something emotionally with their eyebrows, right? Like maybe the more open, the less sort of angry. Let's say this is a face now, right? It's like this versus this person maybe is walking around like this all the time. You see? So, remember how I said you can look at cars and stuff like that and get emotional ideas out of them? Well, each one of the parts of the body can do that as well, right? So here in the mouth, imagine it like the grill of a car. The angles on the lips act, or the philtrum acts like another little emotional design element, right? So this is some really big ones. I'm going to sketch here just really quickly and show you how fast it is to create variety. I just wanted you to see what I'm doing in the background as I'm paying attention to those proportions, right? So very easy to just like put in a mouth line and say, you know what, I want a pretty big upper lip versus maybe a smaller bottom lip, right? So here I'm looking at the width of this versus the width of this. I'm also looking at the height of this versus the height of this. So width by height, width by height. I didn't even put a philtrum in this one, right? And look at just the variation here. So I could say, I want a very skinny, long upper lip with a really wide lower lip. And maybe this one's got a philtrum in it. So it's like this. You see? Damn, isn't that powerful, right? Super simple, really easy and fast, really powerful, right? Suddenly it becomes really quick and fun. I have to say fun, really fun to iterate, right? Let's do one where we make the upper lip smaller, right? And make the lower lip bigger, right? So maybe the upper lip is like this and the lower lip is wider. You know, I've seen people have mouths like this, right? It can add a little bit of structure to this, right? You know, what Mritunjay was talking about before with tone, suddenly I can kind of even imply that there's a little bit of light and shadow on this if I tone the top lip, which is normally how it works because of the sun, right? Because light's usually above. So you got that going on in there, you see? So very fast, very easy. So in my mind, when I iterate, I look at this compared to this. It's width by height, and that's the big picture of the box of the mouth, and then each lip has its own proportional box. And then there's stuff within the mouth itself, like the philtrum, that gives you even more variety, right? We can give somebody a mouth that maybe is really tall on the top, right? What if the mouth was like this? Right? This is kind of very animation, comic bookish kind of mouth, right? Like this. Maybe they have very small lower lip. You see? Oh, isn't that fun, right? Look how quick we can push for character, right? And expression and now design. And then all that, you know, to bring that to what Mritunjay taught you today, you know, imagine I have this plane that's sitting here, and then we go to the mouth in perspective. So like this mouth's really small. I might be able to fit that along the front of the face, right? Here's the turning of the teeth. So here's, let's say, the center line. Here's the nose, right? So here's the nose. Like this, here's a triangle of it. And I can take that mouth and say, okay, you know, let me kind of think of that shape. You know, I'll make it even taller, right? It's like really high up. I want to think about the structure of it. We get that kind of heart thing going in there that Mritunjay brought up. I want to watch the angle of the apexes of the philtrum there, right? And it's a relatively smallish mouth, but really wide on, really tall on the top, I should say, something more like this, right? And then very small bottom. So I angled it. Notice that angle right there helps me push it out, right? Like so. All right. So there it is. I tone it in if I want to add more to it. So I'm basically like mapping. It's like a texture map, right? I'm taking the texture map. I could put it on there and you could start there, maybe get it even flat to sit on that surface, right? Like here's the texture map of the mouth, a sticker, right? And then, you know, go in there further and kind of define the ins and outs that Mritunjay was talking about, right? It's like, I want this to poke out. I want this to go in, right? I want this to come out, right? This is going to go in over here, and then we'll get to the chin, right? Maybe this person's got a little chin. You see? So suddenly you can see how all these things start coming together. It's like, you know, I could push the expression here, right? Some people's mouths, by the way, the length of the lip, the opening of the mouth will go much further than the lip itself, right? So, like here, I can end the lip right there, but push the edge of the mouth, the opening of the mouth, even further, right? I've definitely seen that too, right? But here's our ins and outs. I've got interesting designs, right? I created four very, very quickly for you, as you can see. Then I can map them to the structure of the face. If the mouth was longer, right, things get more challenging because, yes, then I would be having to turn the corner, right? And I like starting with the box. So you have the box like this, but yes, then you round it out, right? You take those corners over there, you round them out, right? And then the mouth suddenly would potentially have to do this and make its way around the corner a little bit, right? So just like I said, depends on the size of somebody's mouth, depends on people's teeth. Some people's teeth are very rounded in the front. Some people's teeth that come down the sides, they are very flat, very boxed out, right? So there's a ton of variety, right? A ton of variety here. We just want to leave you today with some tools, right? Some tools of understanding around force for expression with the mouth, shapes, mouth mask. You've got structure that we talked about. And now we also have this, which is proportion. Taking those interesting designs you're coming up with, and then mapping them, you know, map them over to the face and get some structure out of them, right? Let's see, any questions here? Yes, you could definitely play with convex and concave. You just got to be aware, Dark Knight, that when you do that, you don't end up with bad shape, you know? So So when I'm doing these lips, as quickly as I'm doing them, I'm trying to be aware of, you know, there's still force shape. If you look at this lip, notice the corner of it looks like this, which is a forceful shape, right? So I'm still trying to embed as much shape as I can in here. Innately, and I wrote this to somebody earlier in the chat, you know, if you have that straight mouth and you're doing a lip, you already have a straight to curve shape, right? So it's already like embedded in there. You see, we have this to this. We got two straight to curve shapes, right? So you start there, and things get more complicated, of course, as you add S's to it, you know, and there's different facial expression. I would say probably start with the overarching shape of the mouth like this, I mean, of the lips like this, right? And get those good straight to curve shapes. And then cut in the philtrum, you know, afterwards, because it's hierarchical again. Be aware of the bigger shapes first and then get the other ones in there. And then, of course, don't forget your forms, right? Like, you'll notice here, I just by being putting those lines in there, suddenly I turned this mouth that way, right? It's like, okay, it's like that, right? So it has good shape design, good flow. I can cut the philtrum in there. Here, let's grab this and put it at 100, right? So I can cut that into this, right? But underneath it all, I still got good shape design, right? Let's see, black, right? So we got this, right? And it's appealing. Look, it's got nice flow to it, right? It's got form to it, and it's got good shape design to it. And it's got this S going through it, right? So all these things start stacking on top of one another, okay? All right, with the last few minutes left, let's see what Mritunjay can whip up for us with a little bit of render. All yours, Mritunjay.
Yep. Let's finish it off now.
Icing on the cake.
Yeah, icing on the cake, yeah, literally. So, all right, let me get my paper ready. So I was just like, we have 4 minutes left, probably 3 minutes. So let's get like one really, really quick here. Okay. Now you're going to see me in in a little bit of rush mode or
speed render. Yeah.
Speed render. Yeah. So let's see. I'm just going to draw here really quick for you. So I'm getting this like perspective here. Okay. Now here, just to let you know, I'm drawing from imagination here. So we'll see like how accurate I can go here. But you see, like, the first thing I'm getting is like the overlaps. Okay. This is, I'm really just aware of it, like how much overlaps I'm doing. And then here also I want some overlapping. So I'm rendering an open, a little bit of open mouth here. Okay. And then I want to match up with the center. So here's the center right there. Okay. And then I want to get it relatively flat. Let's see. So let's say this is my design. Okay. This is my lip design. And here you see like there's an overlap here. You remember like I told you about the two ovals, you know, for the bottom here. So these are like the two ovals, and then you're getting this overlap design. Okay, so those are like the overlaps basically, and then that is our mouth, okay, the corner. All right, and here, because we have a little bit of open mouth, I relatively chose this one. I don't know why, but that will give me like a good opportunity for you to like see the teeth right in there. Now with the teeth, it's a little bit, you know, like people struggle with this a lot because, you know, they try to like make individual teeth and it looks bad. So what I will be doing is I'll group them, right? I'll group those teeth together. It's always like the best idea, basically. And then here, the teeth are going inside, okay? So don't just make a line of teeth, okay? Don't just do this and this and this, right? You just want to like wrap it again, okay? So it's going inside this way. Right, even this way, I won't make individual teeth just because they're gonna go in shadows and yeah, they will be hidden. So yeah, that's our lip. And let's see, here's like the line, not here. Here's like the line of mouth or whatever. And then here is the bottom portion right over here quickly. So let's go with this quickly. I'm just gonna shade the upper portion. Okay. It's like a speed render again, just like Mike described it. I'm just gonna go over that. And obviously I will not forget this thing, this weed design here. Right there. Want to make it like a little, you know, gap. It's too wide, you know, right now. Yeah, that is probably better. I'll go over like a little bit of smudge brush here and just kind of like make it a little bit more, I don't know, smoother, you know, because it's lip. needs to get a little bit smoother there. All right, so just like you know, like a little bit of flow there as well. I'm getting that flow. Here I would go like really, really dark, right? Because this is, you just see like a little bit of mouth, you know, it's not the greatest. Yeah, it's really dark down there. And then here I would be doing it a little bit lighter. Now these teeth are no way meant to be left like that, you know, then like that much of light. But as I'm coming all the way here, I'll just darken up more and more. That's weird, teeth. Yeah, darken up more and more because this is like going deep down. Right, something like that. Now I probably have like a shadow over the teeth, so the top lip is casting that shadow on top of the teeth. And yeah, like that. Right, it's and it's going deep down there again. Black. See, I also want to do this. So this is like casting a shadow right there. And then I just want to like give it like a quick core shadow here. Okay, so the core shadow is like, it's literally gonna help me finish this off really quick. And then here I'll give like a definitive border. Okay, right there. And then top here, so basically, wait a second. Just want to show this like overlap a little bit more. Yeah, that's good. Just want to show that overlap there. Yeah, and then I can darken this part up. And then I can come from here. Now see what happened because, you know, the light is, it's also like the little bit of light is coming from side as well, you know. So let's say it's coming from this side because it's wrapping around. You're getting that shadow, okay, on the corners there, because it's wrapping. Okay, so this is like a big, yeah, big yes, you know, you know that you need to do this, okay, right there. And then here with like a little bit of shadow, I'm just managing this up pretty quick. Okay. And right in the end, you know, what I would just love to do here is just like the eyes, the kiss of life, you know. I would give it like a little bit of shadow there. Okay, so the light is coming from here. Let's give it this. Give some highlight right over there. And because this is also like an ovalish form, right? Spherical form, so the light would also hit here. Right. And yeah, I guess, you know, there we go. So hope you enjoyed this this little piece here. No, you can just this is like a very, very quick render. But yeah. Hope you enjoyed this like little part there. Maybe just I'm just gonna go this thing on the teeth and then just describe this form here. Yeah, a little bit like that. Right, so hope you guys enjoyed this little demo. You know, this is like just bringing everything together, you know, and yeah, just having fun, you know, having fun with the mouth. Let's conclude the stream. Stop share.
All right,
Took a long.
guys, that's it. Yeah, that was funny. Nice joke there about the dog and Terminator. Liquid metal flashbacks. So I hope you guys enjoy today's stream, right? So we've covered eyes and mouths in the last couple of weeks. So go have fun iterating, right? We talked about iteration, structure, force to create expression, the sensitivity around expressions, and then finally, even a render here at the end. Have a great weekend, everyone. We will see you next Friday. I believe that Swendly will be returning next week. So hopefully it'll be the three of us again. All right. All right. Take care, guys. Go draw some mouths and eyes. Bye-bye.
Bye, Mike.
See ya.
Bye, guys. See ya.
All right. We're out.
Great.